This video is about post-delivery care. So many people have been asking, what will be the care after cesarean section or a C-section? Something very important that all of you have to understand. It's not a victory to have a normal delivery, and nor it's a failure to have a C-section. Both are equally right, equally important. If it's a medical need, cesarean becomes a lifesaver. If it's not a medical need, you all give you 100% to have a normal delivery. So either ways, as a mother, if you have gone through this entire journey, you are a winner to all of us. Let's understand what are the care that needs to be taken with respect to C-section. Anybody here who is not comfortable with English, we will be doing this video in Marathi as well. You can see it on my Dvija YouTube channel. About cesarean section, there are three types of care which are extremely important. One, what to be done immediately within first 2 hours of delivery. Second, what can be done between the second day to the fifth day, that's when you're getting discharged from the hospital. And third, from the fifth day to first 40 days, what can be done, which is actually lot of cultures follow it as a special care period. Let's understand what will be the relative's role, what will be the husband's role, what can be done under the comma of special attention. First of all, the very fact there is a cesarean section, that means there is a small cut exactly in the lower area. So we call it a C cut, and there is a cut that is given, and inside there are cuts that are given to get the baby out. Usually for cesarean section, the anesthesia that is used is spinal anesthesia. So all of you understand, when there is a cesarean done, within first 2 hours, few things that needs to be done is try and get baby on chest as soon as possible. Either take help of hospital staff, sisters. Second thing which is very much important, immediately after cesarean section might be that girl is not coming out. She might take at least 1 or 2 hours to observe few of the things with respect to her pulse rate, blood pressure, bleeding. Is it normal? Is it more? Is she breathing regularly? Is she recovering proper? To do all these checkups, doctor might keep her under close observation for some time, and that's absolutely normal. Third thing, there are a lot of girls who have got mild shivering kind of a thing after delivery. It's absolutely normal. Put 1 or 2 warm blankets on her and she will feel better. Nothing to feel unusual, abnormal. Within first 2 hours, you will observe 2 drips which are there. One is there on hand, which is saline, from which intake, whatever is needed for that girl right now, is been given by the doctor. And second is at the urinary opening. So urinary catheter is there so that the urine gets passed and it gets accumulated in the small bag that is kept over there. It helps doctors to understand how much urine she is passing out, how well she is taking up all the rest of the treatment after cesarean section, and how much time she is taking to get back to normal. Understand, first 2 hours is not the time where girl will sit, girl will move, girl will start doing her own routine regularly. It's not possible. Because there is an anesthesia on the lower body, she cannot be independently moving, or rather she is not moving for initial 2 to 8 hours. Now next part of the care, after first 2 hours are over, what can be done? First thing, there are a lot of relatives. By this time you all would have called up relatives and informed, and we had a baby girl or a baby boy or whatever. There's a lot of celebration, a lot of guests are coming in. Please understand, this is the time when she needs rest. She must be getting her own spot of rest. So this is a time when she's actually recovering from an anesthesia. So guest, even if you are there, see to it that you sit outside and she gets her due amount of rest. All the relatives, please see to it that don't carry this myth. Because she is not eating anything, there cannot be breast milk flow. Whatever she needs as a food, as a liquid, as a diet, as a nutrition, is being provided by doctors through saline. And that's why it's there. So breast milk doesn't stop just because she is hungry for the day. Please make sure before every feed, child is kept on the chest. Child is put in an effort to suck at the nipples. It will help to settle down her routine slowly across a period of time. if any one of you is not comfortable because she is sleeping straight, how to breastfeed the child, take help of hospital staff and get the breastfeeding started. Earlier it started is always better. Before every feed, child must be kept on mother's breast. It helps bonding to be better, it helps feeding to be settled better, and it's always good. By this time, you'll observe that there is no offering of any kind of a liquid, water or any solids to the mother. Food starts very gradually. Initially, when doctors observe that now she's recovering well, they'll first start with liquids, then soft diet and then solids. Usually post 8 to 10 hours after cesarean section, you will observe that your anesthesia is dropping, you started moving your legs a bit, you might feel pain. They do give you painkillers, antibiotic, through saline, through medicines, but there might be a time where you will feel pain because your uterus is dropping back to its position, which is called as uterus dropping pain. You might have bleeding is because of hormones, you might have slight headaches, slight nausea, slight issue with passing motions, which is again can be there is because of the hormones and because of the delivery process. This is something important because after 8 to 10 hours, depending on doctor's observation and depending on the criteria that they need to tick off before they remove the urinary catheter. So this will be the time when they'll be removing a tube from their urinary opening. First thing, all the mothers, please remember, this is the right time. Once the tube is removed, within next 2 to 3 hours, you must use washroom. You must pass urine. And in case you face any kind of a difficulty, please inform the hospital staff. It's the time when further action needs to be taken. You going through bleeding, that's absolutely normal. In case you're releasing in heavy clots, which are very big, you need to get in touch with hospital staff. They need to take further action. After around 8 to 10 hours, usually doctors start with liquids. So, few sips of water, few sips of nariyal pani, few sips of juices, that's absolutely allowed. And slowly you begin towards getting recovered. After that, after around more 8 to 10 hours, there will be a time where doctor will put you on soft diet. And then slowly they will shift you on a solid diet. Now after this first 10 to 12 hours have passed, what should be the special attention or a care taken till the day when she is getting her discharge from the hospital? Few of the very simple thing, she must get the rest. She must have a food diet properly so that anything about the nutrition is settled in the hospital itself. She must be having her breastfeeding completely set and child should be exclusively on the breastfeeding. So that before you leave from the hospital, whatever clinical help available, you can take use of that and get your normal routine started. Fourth thing, stitches are most probably very less, most of them are not visible, but that does not mean you start bending, you start sleeping on the stomach. Yes, there is a basic care that is needed, but that does not mean you are not doing anything and your all the relatives are taking care of the baby. Basic care of the baby, burping the baby, taking care of the baby, changing the nappy, standing, walking, moving around. These all things must be started within hospital itself. In case your hospital offers basic physio, you need to start with your basic exercises from the second day of cesarean section. If your hospital doesn't provide that facility, do see on my Dvija YouTube channel, there is a video on exercises needs to be done right after delivery. Yes. Even if it's a cesarean section, exercises needs to be started right after delivery from the second day. Now, once you get your discharge, please take discharge looking beautiful. Wear a nice dress, get ready, wear basic cosmetics or the basic makeup that you do, might be kajal, might be lipstick, might be lip gloss. You should look pretty and look very happy because you're taking your little angel back home. Once you arrive at your place, please see to it that pampering don't come all over you. It does not mean you have to be bedridden because you have gone through C-section. You can't move because stitches might open. That's not going to happen. So it's something very simple. Once you are back home, see to it that you get into the basic routine. You need to move regularly, at least 5 to 10 minutes of walk within your house, almost on an everyday basis. Those basic exercises for 40 days morning and evening schedule. You take care of your diet properly. You should eat everything, lot of leafy vegetables, lot of dals, cereals, two fruits every day, and on top of all of these things, right from the second day of your delivery through cesarean section, every day you must be consuming 3 liters of water. This will make sure that your bleeding is smooth, your body is settling, your body is hydrated, and you have a very good milk flow. So water act as a very important ingredient to get the routine set. See to it that even if guests are coming in, you don't sit for long. At the same time, you don't sleep for long. Do everything in a moderate quantity or in a moderate amount. That will definitely help. Once you complete your 40 days, you need to get started gradually on the strengthening, then toning, and then weight loss. So first is strengthening. Strengthening of your core muscles and core belt. So basically you can start with Surya Namaskar, Pilates, core strengthening. Please start it under a person who is knowledgeable or who is knowledge-wise ready to guide you further. So your further recovery can happen. Once you get towards strengthening, after 15 to 20 days of basic strengthening, you get into toning exercises, and after a few weeks of toning exercises, you can think about weight loss without getting into any strict diet. You need to have healthy diet because your child is breastfeeding. See to it that exclusive breastfeeding is on for first 5 months of your child's birth. 6 month onwards, you can start with top food to your child. Thank you so much, all of you. Have a great time. Keep watching my Dwija YouTube channel for this same video. If you wish to see in Hindi and Marathi, keep watching my Dwija YouTube channel. It's there. Thank you. Bye.